guys, welcome back to another video. In today's episode, we'll be playing some more Red Dead Redemption. And I just want to say, guys, sorry for me not uploading for a while. The reason being is my Wi-Fi has just been going down lately, and we've been having trouble with it. So today I thought I'll do a Red Dead Redemption video on the first day of getting it back. So yeah, and in today's episode, we'll be doing our first Seth mission, but first we might actually do a Marshall Johnson mission, you know, save the best till last. So yeah, I'm just gonna get on a horse and ride over there. So I will see you guys when we get there. Okay guys, so we have made it over to Armadillo, and we're just about to go to the Marshall Johnson mission. But first, I want to head over to the gun store just to get some ammo, because I think we've lost quite a lot in our double-barreled shotgun. Sorry, I just can't get my words right. So just gonna walk in there, and normally just hangs around the back here for some reason. But we've got $106, which means we can buy ourselves some shotgun ammo. There we are. So we just got ourselves some shotgun ammo, and how much have we got? Oh, we got 48. Right, too bad. So now we're just gonna go over to do the Marshall Johnson mission right now.
I don't have a clue. All right, but it's gotta be something to do with that government boy.
We'll talk to him, find out what he knows.
He fucking is. Where is she, Marston?
Who?
Who? My daughter, you fucking scum! Where's Bonnie?
I don't know. I haven't seen her since after the fire. Why?
Why? Because she hadn't been seen since yesterday afternoon. You know, I don't think I can cope. If I lose another child...
Now, Drew, nobody's lost anything yet. I'm sure she's fine.
Oh, Mr. Marshall! Mr. Marshall! Come out, wherever you are!
Who the hell's that?
Hey, buddy! That'd be your next fucking mayor.
Even better. Good day, Mr. McFarlane.
Get down from that horse, boy, or I'll shoot.
I wouldn't recommend that, mister. Not if Drew McFarlane wants to see his bunny back in one piece. Hey, Mr. McFarlane! It's a nice girl you got there.
Get down from there!
You know, part of me's got to thinking I should just marry her myself. Give her a baby and that.
What do you want?
That's better. I want Norman Deke. I want him set free. Then you'll get your daughter back, mister.
We don't do deals with outlaws, boy.
Yeah, you do! Let's not waste each other's time pretending otherwise. Whole government themselves ain't much more than a bunch of crooks. This is the land of opportunity, mister. And I'm giving you the opportunity to get your daughter back before 15 friends of mine take out all their anger and their loneliness on her.
Where the hell is she?
Where is she, boy?
Bring Deke up to Tumbleweed in a couple hours. And don't get no funny ideas, or I will slit that horse throat myself. You boys have a pleasant afternoon. Yeah!
What do we do?
We do as he says. You and me, Marshal. Mr. McFarlane, I'll get you your daughter back. I owe her that.
Please do.
I'll teach you some respect for the law. Hurry up, boy. Let's go.
Quick as you can, deputy. Make sure he's tied on good.
Stay with me, Marston.
I won't let anything happen to her, sir.
Okay, so we gotta go rescue Bonnie McFlan, because she's being captured by the outlaws. I'm not too sure if it's that same gang we fought earlier in the game, but we'll just have to find out.
How you say that, John, but the only thing I know for sure is who sent you.
They made me come here. They gave me no choice.
That's your federal government, Mr. Johnson.
They come down here dressed as cocky as the King of Diamonds, talking a lot of flannel about helping us, about spreading peace and civilization to the West, but they brought nothing but trouble and taxes.
I agree with you. Wolves in sheep clothing, all of them. Rob you, then make you pay to have someone investigate the crime on your behalf.
People around here have been fooled into feeling protected, when they're worse off than they were before.
The fellas I know don't care about people. All they care about is lining their pockets. Why's this sorry son of a bitch so important to them?
Norman Deeks Williamson, right-hand man. In other words, a glorified errand boy.
You wait, Marshal! I'll be back for you!
Bill's standards have slipped.
We already filled you with lead once, you ugly bastard!
Deeks the kind of man who's mean enough to be second in command, but too cowardly and stupid to ever be a leader.
Don't ever use that line near your deputies. You know, for his sake, they'd best not have laid a finger on Miss McFarland. What is this place we're headed?
Tumbleweed? A lonely, godforsaken place. Some people say it's haunted. It was quite a town back in its day. Then they built the railroad to Armadillo and went clean past Tumbleweed. And that was that. Pretty soon, everybody had up and left. Now it's just thieves, smugglers, and bandits. Scum like Deke here. Oh, popular spot for lynchings, too.
Let's try to avoid that if we can, Marshal.
I just hope you're not taking advantage of the McFarland, Marston.
They saved my life. Gave me food and bed when they had no idea who I was. I owe them more than I can ever repay.
That's just they've been through a lot. Well, they're both vulnerable, in different ways.
I wouldn't have been running in and out of a burning barn to save their horses otherwise.
I know you helped. Just like you helped me. But you got your reasons for doing it.
It's no secret why I'm here, Marshal. I told you the very first time I walked into your office.
I trust you. It's just all this business with Blackwater and Williamson in the past. I don't know. Sometimes it's hard not to have doubts.
I understand. I never planned to be in the lawman business neither.
How is this mess supposed to turn out? Sending an outlaw to do the work of a lawman. That's madness.
Ain't much difference between the two, as far as I can tell.
There have to be rules, Marston. Even you must understand that.
It's easy to make up rules, but they ain't much use if people don't understand why. Like my son. If I tell him not to do something, he'll do it anyways, just to spite me. If I punish him, he resents me for it. But if I show him why it's wrong, at least he has reason not to do it again.
That's nonsense. Without laws, we're nothing more than animals. Just look at Deke here.
Go to hell!
Man has worked hard at civilization. Your boy steps out of line, you whack him. He does it again, whack him harder.
You're a good man, Marshal, and I respect what you're trying to do. From what I've seen since I've arrived here, the law ain't really working.
Criminals are like weeds, Marston. Quick as you stomp one out, another one sprouts up in its place.
I hope they haven't spoiled her yet. I ain't had my turn.
Ew.
Oh, slow down, will ya?
Okay, so we're nearly at Tumbleweed. And we're just gonna fight some bandits when we're there. As you can see, the bridge is broken and this place is abandoned.
You'll be exchanging the prisoner for Bonnie in the middle of town. Keep your eyes open. I sincerely doubt these scum plan to play fair.
Fair my ass.
You bet. Besides, Norm here's gonna be my shield, ain't you, Norm?
It'd be my pleasure.
John, you lead Deke into town.
Okay, so we are moving Norm and Deke into the town. And it's gonna be our shield just in case they start shooting.
Rancher girls like it in the rear. Maybe she won't wanna go home. She's been fucked so good. Get these ropes off me, boys!
Where's Bonnie? I thought we had a deal.
Well, you thought wrong. We don't make deals with the law.
Okay, so they have just started the fight, so we need to go and find Bonnie. Because we need to fight our way to her.
Let her go. We're off to every last one.
There we are. Need to fight our way through the town. So we need to fight our way over to Bonnie.
Leave her alone! Someone might as well have this. When are you sending the men out to fight?
Okay, so we need to loot some of these corpses because I can get a lot of stuff like I said in a few episodes ago.
She ain't involved in this. Touch her again and you're all dead. Stop playing tough and run off back to mom.
Right, Bonnie's near death, so we need to act fast. Finish off the remaining outlaws. There we are.
Christ alive.
I think the last one's run off. So I think we can loot all the other ones. Okay, so we're just gonna go over to Bonnie now.
Bonnie, are you okay?
I'm fine now, Mr. Marston. Thank you. Thank you. What the hell took you so long, you stupid man?
Well, you weren't exactly helping me.
If you think I'm gonna lower myself by making a joke about being all tied up, you got another thing coming. Come on.
Okay, so we just completed this mission. Now what we need to do is go over to the S on the map, which is going to be our first Seth mission. Well, mission for Seth. Of course. So we're just gonna get on our horse. And I'll see you when we make it over there. Okay, so we're over at the church where the Seth mission is. And what we'll be doing is we'll be just making it over to where Seth is. So just arriving there right now. Just making it over to the gravesite.
Excuse me, are you Seth?
Who are you?
I'm a friend of Mr. West Dickens. My name's Marston. John Marston.
Goodbye, John Marston. It's been a great pleasure.
I need your help, Seth. We need your help. Me and Mr. West Dickens.
Let me be frank for 1 second, partner. I hate people. It was people who got me in this mess in the first place.
What mess?
Look at me. Look, scrambling around, looking for maps, half insane. I ain't washed in 6 months. My hair falling out, my mind's going.
What happened?
What happened? My partner. He stole half my map. I never would have done that to him. Never. Look at me.
Who did this to you?
My partner. My boy, my man. Moses Forth. I don't have the facility to tell you what I would have done for that man. And what I would do to him now.
Why?
Because he stole half my goddamn map.
And what map's that, then?
The map, partner. The map that tells me where it is.
Where what is, friend?
I ain't telling you that. I ain't. Don't make me tell, partner. It's mine. It's mine. All mine.
Sure. And where's this Moses now?
He's at Benedict Point. The law got him for exhuming. Some people, they feel differently. Not Moses. Him and me are the same. The self-same.
Well, come on, Seth. Let's go see Moses. Get you your map back. Then maybe you'll help me.
All right, partner. Let's go.
Okay, so we're in-game, and we're gonna follow, Seth right now. And I think we're gonna go to, I think it's Tumbleweed. Because I remember doing this mission. I mean, we've just gone to Tumbleweed, now we're going back. So we're just gonna keep following him.
How can you sink that low? Digging up graves and looting from the dead.
Ha, hypocrites! The whole damn lot of you! Are you saying it's better to steal from the living? They're corpses! They don't care none!
These people have been laid to rest.
You don't know nothing. I talk to them long after they've been forgotten by every other fella. I tell them it's all right to be scared and alone. I embrace them when they're stinking and rotten.
I met some sick bastards in my time, Seth. But you? You're special.
Folk is cold and heartless all their lives. To me, they gets warmer when they're actually cold and heartless. Surely that makes sense to even you.
Not exactly, it don't.
Are we really living anyway? Do you exist outside my mind? Maybe we're both having the same dream, and when we wake up, we'll die.
I certainly seem to be in some kind of nightmare.
Have you looked in the cave, Seth?
It's very dark.
What'd you say?
I didn't say nothing.
I just heard you say something.
You're a crazy man. You should get that head looked at.
Seth, I need someone who can get a wagon inside Fort Mercer. I was told you could help me, but I'm not sure you even know what day it is.
I don't. I can't even tell you what year it is.
I knew this was a waste of time.
So, you want to go after Bill Williamson, do you?
You know Bill?
Oh, yes. I'm at Williamson and Deke and all them boys. Sometimes they call me on when they get some special job needs doing. I got a reputation as a man who do things most other fellers won't.
Now, that I can believe.
I reckon you can get in there, no bother. Assuming you help me find this map, that is. Fly! Fly!
What's so important about this map?
Nothing much. Just unimaginable riches and such like. A spark of hope that lit a raging fire I can't put out.
I thought as much. Another treasure hunter losing everything in the search for nothing.
Oh, I lost it all, partner. My wife, my children, my business. Good riddance to them all. I don't eat, I don't sleep, I don't wash, and I don't care.
I know. I can smell you from here.
It used to be about the money, but now, I don't know who I am no more. I see myself, but it's like I'm looking at
okay, so we're
else.
Near Benedict's Point, well, so we're just gonna run up there right now.
Whoa there!
All right, this is it. Let's stop here a moment and come up with a plan. As far as I know, Moses is being held in that shack. There's a couple of deputies keeping guard outside.
Can you distract him so I can sneak in for a quick parlay with that son of a bitch?
I'm sure I can think of something.
Leave them away from the shack and out of sight. Somewhere out past that hill.
So, actually, I was wrong. This isn't the tumbleweed mission I was talking about. So, we just need to steal a deputy's, horse. There we are. I need to lose the wanted level. I'm just losing it right now. There we are. I've just lost it, so I need to return to Seth.
Good job getting rid of them clowns. Now keep an eye out in case they come back. Moses? Oh, Moses! You got a visitor.
Oh, my God, Seth. They arrested me. It weren't my fault. Ah! Get the hell away from me!
Get that slippery bastard! I need him alive, though!
Okay, so we gotta go get him. Gotta go lasso him. Need to run after him. Now, we're not gonna kill him. We need to just capture him. Okay. Yes, so we got him. Right, just hog tie him. There we are. So we need to pick up Moses.
Who do you think you are, mister?
Just gonna run over to Seth.
You just wait till I get loose, mister. Seth would sell his own mother. You must be stupid trusting that crazy bat.
Did you think I wouldn't find you, Moses? Moses, you son of a bitch! Where's my damn map?
Damn you, Seth! Damn you, Seth! You've always been a twisting little freak. I ain't telling you shit.
Then I'm gonna cut you up piece by piece. Till you find your tongue.
Friend, this man's gone crazy in the sun. I suggest you take my advice and start talking.
Shut up, Marston! I want to cut into a bona fide man's flesh. Ain't never cut into a live one before.
Odd fellow's rest. It's an odd fellow's rest. Get away from me once and for all.
Well, ain't that a damn shame? I was starting to enjoy myself. I think you gone pissed yourself, Moses.
Those deputies went and put a bounty on your head. Best we clear it now. Don't need the law on our backs. I don't have no money, but I got me a pardon letter. Here, take it. You earned it for helping me with Moses. Come on. We can pay it off in the telegraph office.
Come on. Okay, so we got a pardon letter, and what this means is that we can go pay off our bounty. So we need to go to the telegraph office. So, yeah. Now we just need to give pardon letter.
I've got a letter here that pardons my crimes.
You better go straight now, like me.
There we are. Done it.
So, mister, thanks for your help.
Don't worry yourself with thanks, Seth. Just help me when I come asking.
No problem, mister.
Okay, so we've just won this, just done the mission. So this is the end of the video, guys. Thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you all later. Bye.